Right, Vince, you heard the ring announcer talking about the next wrestling event will be sometime after the first of the year because of conflicts in booking. Why, we know wrestling in December here at the Spectrum. But the rest of the evening ought to be interesting. Of course, we're looking forward to a great month of wrestling here in the Philadelphia area come January, resuming 1980. Well, Vince, we've got more action coming up. Do we notice that Davey Hammond, perhaps, is on the...
I don't know if he's going to join us or not. I didn't see him in the battle
royal.
I don't know if he's here or not. Of course, we are waiting for the World Wrestling Federation title match back on against Pat Patterson. We've made numerous references to that earlier. I think it's certainly worthy of noting that perhaps as you saw in the Cardinals before the show began tonight, Bob Backlund working out almost fanatically. Backlund is really keyed up for the match, and Backlund feels that he was done an injustice here by the officials in the previous contest. Not that he will publicly say so, but Backlund, I think, feels that he should not have been disqualified. I think most of the fans would concur that he should not have been disqualified. It was a rough and tumble type match, and the referee obviously was going to allow a great deal of latitude in the bending of the rules, if you would, with Patterson and Backlund. And not that you can say the referee favored Pat Patterson, but nevertheless, that's the way the things of things went.
Yeah, Steve and Dick Worley favored Patterson, the challenger, but the fans, of course, never like it when they see Backlund in jeopardy. They see perhaps losing his title or almost losing it. He didn't really. Speaking of Backlund, the prison sports director, Jim Barniak, early this evening did an interview, which will be seen later on his one-to-one sports feature, one-on-one. And that'll be coming up very shortly, not tonight, of course. He'll be seen very soon on Prism Television. So I think you might be interested in the various comments, the answers to Jim Barniak's questions on Prism Television about wrestling and how he feels about the competition, how he does as a wrestling champion, because he's all of that. And I think you'll find it very interesting. So you'll be looking for that feature on Prism Television in the future. Speaking now of action, though, we've got Ted DiBiase coming ringside. He'll be going into the ring. And this guy, of course, has gained a lot of local recognition, as also national recognition. And speaking of his appearances at the Spectrum in the past, he's gained a lot of popularity here, and a lot of fans like his style. Clean cut and very youthful and a real comer. All right, Sweet Hansen's the other half of this match, so let's see what's going on.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next match is set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, weighing 307 pounds from Slaughter's Creek, North Carolina, Sweet Hansen. And his opponent from Omaha, Nebraska, 251 pounds, Ted DiBiase.
Hansen with a rather unusual color hair, wouldn't you say?
Yes. Who's going to tell him it's unusual?
Not too many people, but from our vantage point, perhaps we could describe it and get away with it. It kind of looks like a sort of a...
An already saw, well, reddish auburn or whatever.
Sort of an ox blood shoe polish effect, perhaps.
All right, I'm going to tell him you said that, sir.
No.
Sorry about that. All right, we've got the very plodding and methodical style of Sweet Hansen, and the very quick. Oh, no way. Sorry. Whoops. Pardon me. You'll excuse me while I talk things over with myself. Okay, DiBiase was all ready for that one, pounding off the rope, gaining momentum, because he was all set to deliver probably a karate chop. Sweet Hansen shaking a finger at DiBiase. They have none of that.
Hansen's mean, tough.
Yes, he is.
300-pounder. True veteran of pro wrestling. He's been around a long time. Knows all the ins and outs. Quick, go down, back up, Hansen, so. Look at this.
Hansen. Hansen was down on one knee, back up, and then down the other knee after getting a a forearm to the top by DiBiase. The contrast in colors in their footwear. DiBiase with the red wrestling shoes and green, the lightest green by Sweet Hansen. Hansen, colorful in his style. Still shaking the cobwebs on that one.
And DiBiase is very alert, I think, in not moving in a moment ago when you would normally think you have a big man like Hansen on the run. Hansen certainly not on the run. Hansen's type of man takes so much punishment. Nice takedown there by Hansen, and a very nice escape and reversal somewhat of Ted DiBiase.
Well, DiBiase showing his skill, and what we look for here, Hansen coming over the top to try for a pin.
Hansen very obviously pretty much with ease a moment ago.
I really don't know where he can go with this.
Nice maneuver. From that vantage point, DiBiase can inflict quite a bit of pain from the scissor there. If Hansen is able to spin around and face Danucci somewhat, then the leverage factor is certainly not what it is here. That's a big, thick neck Hansen has, so I really don't know how much damage you do to it. Although the knee will definitely put the hurting on him, so to speak.
Well, he caught him right in the Adam's apple with the knee, and that'll make your breath come in short fast. A little inactivity here right now. DiBiase maintaining the hold. Hansen trying to break the, pull the knee away from front of his face, hoping to relieve the pressure.
Oh, look at that. Uh-huh. Cleverly done.
Yes.
Cleverly done.
So there's, come see, come saw. We got a... who's got whom?
Yeah, I'll say.
Hume. I got Hume. All right. Hansen bullied his way out of that.
Ooh,
and a flat to the back of the head. That wasn't a fist. That was an open hand.
All nice and legal-like.
Yep. Oh, yeah. Hello there. That, I don't believe, was open hand at all. That was a fist. DiBiase really shaking his head on that. The takedown. Hair. DiBiase trying desperately to get out of this, taking his body back and forth, trying to break the hold, and not so. Pulled down again by Hansen. Was super concerned about the choking aspect, but apparently no.
Hansen, mean-looking individual, isn't he?
Yep.
Disposition to match. There's an unusual camper shot.
Really hard after you've seen the battle royal as we have earlier tonight to come back up again in a sense, because there's so much action at one time, and now we're back to just normal wrestling, if you will, and the action flows here and there, but it's interesting watching these guys trade holds back and forth. But right now DiBiase's not doing too very well. His arm's kind of limp, and Lou Chupa asking if he can hear him at all. Do you submit? And DiBiase, I don't know, maybe out of it. Doesn't look too good for him. And we'll get a shot here, I think, in a second. A front shot. There's DiBiase seemingly catching a few winks, but not really. He's still feeling some pain, and perhaps he still raises his arm. He's still in it. Let the fans know he's not out, nor does he submit. Both hands now, and he's trying to get himself together. Perhaps get a little traction with his feet. Moving a lot of weight in back of him, and Sweet Hansen.
Awesome.
All right. Still not out of it, but they made a valiant try, and perhaps through sheer determination and
strength. He is out now.
He is out.
He's powering his way out of it.
He's reversing it.
That's really surprising, considering that.
There's a hair pull takedown. Lou Chupa, the referee, in the wrong spot to notice the hair pull takedown, but anyway, fans caught it. As we did. you see almost a replay of the earlier bit with the pressure applied to the head and neck area. DiBiase by Sweet Hansen. But DiBiase, I don't know, is he out this time? No, he says he's summoning strength from somewhere, coming from his toes on up to his body, I guess. What a competitive athlete he is. DiBiase just trying to get together. Once out of this,
bridging back to his feet, and again he tries the same ploy of trying to power his way out. And Lou Super in perfect position now to see if there's going to be a hair pull.
Yeah, maybe we'll see. Yeah, there we are.
But DiBiase breaks it up.
All right. Played a nice elbow on Sweet Hansen, buying himself some time to get himself together. Hansen obviously not ready to stand erect at the present time. But DiBiase he's almost wiped out. He's very, very weak. The fans are trying to give some of their strength to him at ringside, cheering him on, and seemingly transmitting that strength. So DiBiase is starting to inflict a little punishment on Sweet Hansen. Series of punches to the midsection, the upper head area, upper chest. Oh, bye-bye. Whoa! I think the ring moved about a foot or two on that. DiBiase going out for the back of Sweet Hansen. Riding his knees.
Oh, look at this. Look at that.
DiBiase wants to pay him back. He's not ready to pin him. I still know whether I would wait around.
Elbow, now he'll go for the cover. Spin
around.
Right, here
we are.
Does not hook the leg, however.
Slow count, I think, Vince. Lou Super, the slow count of two, or maybe two and a fraction. Sweet Hansen barely on his knees, seemingly. But still in this to the finish. DiBiase.
DiBiase in training punches with Hansen, I would think, would lose that particular type of encounter, although DiBiase's coming on strong. DiBiase getting in more punches.
I don't know. Take your pick. Who's going to have left?
Just flies with each blow.
Oh. I don't think you can hurt Sweet Hansen very much hitting him in the midsection.
Pass it down. DiBiase now. Oh, look out.
All right, DiBiase over the top of the rope. And you see him a few feet away from our location, flat out on the floor. Hansen not in very good shape himself inside the ring. Sort of rolling around trying to get himself together. DiBiase fell flat on his back after his feet hit. All right, there goes the bell. That seems to be time has run out. Well, there you see Ted DiBiase in the lower left of the ring, trying to get back, but it's all over now. The ring bell is rung.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the match, 9 minutes, 25 seconds. DiBiase countered out of the ring. Your winner, Sweet Hansen.
Sweet Hansen got the nod there through the count. Ted DiBiase doesn't believe it. But Hansen says enough's enough. I won, so I'm leaving.
DiBiase with a few choice words there for Sweet Hansen.
Hansen keeps on walking. He's satisfied. Live to wrestle another day is his motto. Here's a little slow-mo action. DiBiase now with being thrown into the ring rope and now caroming off with a shoulder block on Sweet Hansen. Going off the ring to get more, and over the top and along the side where we are, and flat on his back, and there you see it.
And his head rammed into the iron gate there. We didn't see that.
I didn't see that either, Fitz. You're right.
I think that really was what did him in.
But he was definitely down and out, and that's the way it went. All right, you heard the announcement, and the crowd settling down here because we're looking for the title affair. That'll be the match between the return to returned by popular demand between the champion Bob Backlund.